Hi, welcome to my channel. I'm going to tell you my spring break experience in LA. My dad and I arrived at Los Angeles around 6 p.m. and on our way to my brother's place. But first, we went to a hot pot restaurant to check out the wondrous noodle dancing and not to mention celebrating my brother's belated birthday. And one thing you should know about my brother, that he's a very, very heavy sleeper. So my dad and I decided to walk out for a bit. And while I was walking, I saw a cement writing with my name on it, and I felt like a caterpillar is about to sprout in me and turn into a butterfly. And speaking of that, I found a little wormy creature, and bringing him to a place to not get squished, that I actually tried to scare my sister-in-law, but then it accidentally fell to the ground very badly. Well, not badly, he's fine. But anyways, we went to the most tourist beach attraction ever, the Santa Monica Beach, to actually pick up a key card from my sister-in-law's workplace that after we got out, I confronted her of what I tried to do.
I actually tried to scare you with a worm.
We then walked down to the pier and walked to the end, and throughout the walk, my dad, my brother, and my sister-in-law were bickering about management, that at the end of the pier, I just stared out and think of an inspirational quote. When life gives you lemons, make lemonade. Unless you want to be pulpy or fresh or sour, I don't know what this stupid phrase means anyways. That after walking out to the pier, things turned very sour when seeing someone arrested from a knife fight, but got some very fresh fruits from a Mexican fella. Then drove to see the Hollywood sign, well actually not on top of the sign, just the view of it. And very want to hike the way up, but they don't have the steam to do it. So I decided to walk up for myself to get a more closer look at it. And while I was walking, one thing has raced into my mind.
Oscars next week. Who wants to watch that?
True, but the view was outstanding, and walking more closely to get a view of the Hollywood sign, that I decided to go back down to make sure they didn't leave me. And when I got back down, to my surprise, they were sitting down like a bunch of potatoes. And went back to my brother's place, and I was being a potato as for myself, and just two more episodes away from the second season of Euphoria. And in my opinion, it was fucking wild. Speaking of wild, we then went to the place with popular cartoon characters and also brought my plushy companion with me to my actual first time of Disneyland. That back then I only had been experiencing Disney World several times, that I hadn't gotten a chance to experience this magnificent land by going on Rise of Resistance, and just love being held as prisoner, being rescued, and then getting chased by Kylo Ren. And seeing a few stormtroopers that a little girl asked them a very funny question. Then heading to the Haunted Mansion, and it wasn't very pleasant, of not a lot of rooms to explore, and it always breaks down, and also a similarity to the ride of Astro Blaster that squeezed in the trigger several times, very cramped my fingers and breaks down as well, but at least to get more points to become a galactic superstar. Then getting some food at Cafe Orleans and trying their exquisite gourmet of starting off the Ratatouille crostini and the Ferro risotto, and they were amazing. Then trying out the new web slinger, and it's way better than Astro Blaster, of developing a very great wrist flinking to the screen.
Look at the flick of that wrist.
Then going on to the Incredicoaster, and not as fast, but good of seeing Jack's power develop throughout the ride. And finally going on to the Pixar Pal Around, that we went on to the swinging side, and to my surprise, my sister-in-law reaction was traumatized by the swing movement.
What's wrong with the swing? What's wrong with the swing?
That she doesn't want me to swing it.
Don't swing.
Okay, don't swing.
I lied, that fortunately these two cool women riders started to rock back and forth, that I joined as well.
Work it together, ladies!
No, work it. Don't.
Yes!
It was all fun and games until the second time around, I started developing something very upsetting in my stomach, that I was about to puke and about to like break the ride.
Say hi to my vlog.
Hey.
That after that, the fun is done and just went straight back home.
Pro tip. Don't eat when going on a wobbly ride.
If you're too hungry, you will get sick too.
Oh, whatever.
And bought some Advil and decided to rest for the next day. Then I started to take a jog down that surprisingly, my brother's place is closer to the Santa Monica Beach, but didn't get a chance to reach it because of the crazy maniacs that are out there. Speaking of Santa Monica, I went back there to meet up with my cousins. Hey!
Hi!
That they wanted to go on to the rides, but I held back due to the fun and almost a puking accident in Disneyland. That I decided to play a ring toss game that I ain't very good at it till someone gave me advice to swing my arm upward, not straight forward. And after their fun is done, we went straight down to the pier and enjoyed the amazing sunset and the guitar's beautiful singing melody. Gorgeous. Speaking of gorgeous music, we went to the Griffith Observatory where they shot a scene from La La Land. Then I saw this bench, and yeah, it's not the bench from the location where it was shot for A Lovely Night. Then I just gave it a shot anyways. Then we headed inside of the observatory and where they shot Ryan Gosling and Emma Stone walking around the pendulum clock, and as for the Tesla coral, it wasn't turned on, but amazed of seeing the planets align, that speaking of musicals or plays, that I went to see a show here in Los Angeles that I didn't get a chance to see on Broadway, but was transported to here when I saw the banners while I was jogging yesterday, that it's, you know what, cue the car. That it talks about the rise and the downfall of these three brothers company corporation that, whoop, shh, the play is about to begin, but every time when it's intermission or the end of the play, I give my feedback on what I enjoy and don't enjoy. So, take away me.
Alright, act one is done and it's intermission. And it's a good start of how these brothers come out like a ghost and talk to these audience about these three brothers and how they start their business and playing other characters throughout the story of the Lehman brothers. Can't wait to see act two and see how the story goes on. Alright, that's the end of act two and it's another intermission. And I like it how the sons of the original of the three Lehman Brothers are following their father's footsteps and giving them an example of what it's like to work for investing the money, like for like seeing a horse race or any other examples that when they were younger and then becoming older and working in the Lehman Corporation in New York. Can't wait to see the final act and see what's gonna happen at the end. Done, and oh my gosh, that was a good history play of the rising and the falling of the Lehman Brothers. And when the janitor in the beginning was cleaning up the corporation, the ghost came out and then just talking in third person and just playing as other characters. And also, I really like the piano score that goes along of the story, and also with the movements and the speed and the tempo of all these three actors are developing on stage. And also, one thing that I just don't like is just the dance of it a little bit, because it's a little bit cheesy and quirky, but 9 out of 10. 9 out of 10. I love it. Love this. Love the play.
That, speaking of downfalls, that I saw a demolition of a house getting teared to pieces, that I didn't eat any breakfast, that we went to a farmer's market and the freshness of strawberries and berries were just wonderful to taste, that one of the market's strawberries were sweeter than the rest, that I got strongly addicted to it but was mainly hungry because I didn't eat any goddamn breakfast, and we drove a whole 1 hour place to a dim sum place in Irving, and in my mind I was still hungry, but my sister-in-law said that she was very high standards for dim sums.
I have high standard for the dim sum, and this place is one of the few that meets my standard. I like this place.
And once we sat and ordered, I just quickly snagged the food away from everyone because of how extremely hungry I was and didn't eat any goddamn breakfast!
Joey doesn't share food!
That after that I felt very bellied up but need to blow off some steam, then I went to an indoor go-karting and I was doing better of the first race than the second race. Then on our final day we went to another beach area and enjoyed the windy time and remembering the fun that I had done that I don't want to leave but will surely remember the great things that I did and gaze out on the sands of Malibu Beach. In Malibu. Next to you.
Standing.